In this video, we will cover the graph view in the Disassembly window. Last time we mentioned that you can switch between the views by pressing the spacebar. What you see here is the current function represented by a flowchart of blocks, also known as nodes, linked together with edges. These are the arrows between the nodes. It is important to know that IDA displays only one function at a time. Each node corresponds to a basic block. The basic block is a straight sequence of instruction with a single entry point and a single exit point. This is the last instruction in the block. Quite often, the entry point is the target of a branching instruction, and the exit point is either a branch or a return instruction. As you can see, the arrows, or the edges, are colored differently, and that's because of the different types of flows between the basic blocks. Conditional jumps have two outgoing edges, a green edge illustrating the flow when the branch is taken or the condition is satisfied, and the red edge when the branch is not taken. The blue edge, called the normal edge, is used when a basic block flows or jumps unconditionally to the next. The thick edges that go backward in the flowchart or the graph often represent a loop. When in graph mode, by default, IDA trims some parts of the disassembly that would be shown in flat mode. For example, line address prefixes. That's only for space optimization purposes. You can add more pieces of information by opening Options, General, when in Graph mode, then switch to the Disassembly tab. Here are a few additional operations you can perform with the mouse. Mouse wheel scroll vertically, Alt plus mouse wheel scroll horizontally, Control plus mouse wheel zoom in or out. The hotkey W fits the whole graph in the visible area of the window. Alternatively, right-click with the mouse and select Fit in Window. To zoom back to 100%, press 1, or right-click and select Zoom 100% from the context menu. If you would like to move to the parent or child node, use the Control Up or Control Down shortcut and choose the wanted node from the selector. On the left side of the screen, you will notice the graph overview window. It shows the complete block structure of the graph. The dashed area indicates the region of the graph that is currently viewed. It can be dragged around to reposition the graph view. Another possibility is to click and drag on the background in the graph view window to pan the graph in any direction. Double-click on an edge jumps to its destination. If you just hover over an edge, it will show you a preview of its destination. Sometimes you might want to rearrange nodes and/or edges. You can move around a block or several selected blocks by clicking on its or their title and dragging it or them to a new position. The same rules apply when moving around an edge. Just click on one of its bending points and drag it to the wanted position. To revert it to the original layout, right-click and select Layout Graph. From time to time, you might want to group several blocks. To do that, select the nodes you want to group by holding the Control key and click on their titles. Or you can also control and drag a selection box. These nodes have a different title color. Right-click and choose Group Nodes from the context menu and give a name for the new node. You can see that IDA has replaced the selected nodes with a new one and rearranged the graph. You can also group already grouped nodes. It is good to know that you can rename the group title, change the node color, expand, collapse, hide or unhide, or ungroup the blocks. Finally, you can add more disassembly views by going to Views, Open Subviews, Disassembly. That's quite useful when you want to view graphs of two functions simultaneously. We hope that you enjoyed this video. Show us how we did it below, and don't forget to keep following our channel for more helpful content.